Hey, what's up, everyone? Thank you guys for joining. And today I am BK back with another banger. Today I'm showing how to use the network MIDI, the Akai Network MIDI. It was released in the 2.7 update. It was released and it's basically centered around controlling Ableton Live, but you can also use it within other DAWs, such as I'm going to show you how to use it in Studio One today, but you can use it in all DAWs basically. So you need two things, well, a few things. You need either an MPC X or an MPC Live or the new MPC One that's gearing to ship out soon. You need an interface. This is a Persona Studio 2.4 USB. It has the mic inputs. This one has two. You need your, what's this, the XLR cables. I'm only using two for this instructional. But if you have a bigger one that has, or a mixer with an interface that has six or eight outputs, you can plug up all your six to eight outs, ins and outs, right? I'll just be using this. So keep in mind, you definitely need an interface for this to work. Now, it says live control seamless integration. You can now control Ableton Live using MPC X or Live or One. Your MPC X, Live or One comes pre-mapped to Ableton Live 10.1.2 or later for an instant performance and production setup for cableless operation. That's the key thing. It's cableless. You don't need the MIDI, right? So we used to have to use the 5-pin MIDI then. I don't have one right here to show you, but we all know what the MIDI is. Tier in and out. And you also have that on the back of your MPC X, MPC Live, MPC Renaissance, MPC Touch. It's not on the studio, so keep that in mind. All right. You can also use an Ethernet adapter to USB for the live but then that gives you connection via cable. We want to do this wireless. That's the whole thing about this. So that's enough of me talking about that. What I'm going to do is close this screen right here and show you the setup. So this is the Akai Professional Network MIDI. Right now there's no configured devices. Says it's not available because I don't have my MPC Live hooked up. So I'm gonna turn on my MPC Live. I don't have another camera, but we all know what the MPC Live looks like. So as soon as I turned on my MPC Live, it automatically sees the device. It picks it up automatically. The remote device is discovered. One, because I only have one connection right now. I'm curious to know if you can have multiple connections at once. That'd be cool, right? So I have Studio One open up, just a blank session. I pulled in Presence and I have a blank audio track. So you go to your audio track, you go to here where it says none, go down to audio IO setup. Now this should already be set up for me. Why is it not? All right, so I had to set up the IO device because it forgot it somehow. So you want to open up your track. Say you open up a new track, you open the track, it's blank. It would be on none right here. You click on that and you go to input one and two. If this input one and two is not here, this is for you Studio One users. If this input one and two isn't here automatically, you go down to audio IO setup and if this isn't here, right? Say it's blank like that. You'd add it. You'd add a stereo. It opens up. And then you're good to go. You apply it, hit okay, go back here, and there it is. And now you'd have to put monitor on in order to hear it. Press your space bar. Now, there's a little lag in it, but the lag is not that bad. You want to record it, you record enable. Put the punch in on. You hit record. Now you have it in. Take off record enable. Make sure you take the monitor off, because if you leave the monitor on, you'll get that doubling flanger effect like this. If you take the monitor button off, you're good. Now, the record offset, you want to set this to whatever specifically works for you. This was the setup that I had with the Mayo MIDI. So this, I set that up for that. It worked for a little bit of time and then it stopped working. So we off that, but that's how you set that up right there. In order to get it to, because right now it's playing off, you got to find the time, the delay, the latency, right? So you set that how you set it. And that's pretty much that. Now you need to have the MTC on, right? I said that in prior videos. You want to set the MTC up. Once you... you go in here, you receive from the network MIDI, send to the network MIDI, and you want to send MIDI timecode, right? Let me just see if I put it on use MIDI clock start, is it still going to work? Let's check it. Doesn't hurt to try. All right, let's delete that. That was way late. That was way late. I mean, it's a little delay in there, but once you figure out that delay time, you should be wonderful. Now, the network MIDI DAW function, it's not working as it should be, or as they intend it to work is not controlling the MIDI. I'll put a, let's mute that. I'll add an instrument. Let's go to a default piano. And the MPC is set to on a MIDI track itself. And it's going out port A. And this thing is not working. So all inputs should be fine. We want it to be, let me see. So the MIDI isn't working as far as controlling audio. As far as controlling audio, it is not working, right? Put it on a DAW control. Same deal. It's not receiving the network Bluetooth wireless Wi-Fi. And keep in mind, you need a Wi-Fi connection. Like your MPC Live X or MPC One needs to be on the same Wi-Fi connection. Your router, it needs to be on the same network. That's the only way this is gonna work. I guess in future updates, this control will be working, but that's pretty much how you do it. You need an interface with ins and outs, and you can do seamless audio dragging, and you could do multiple outs at one time. Just set up your tracks. I'll show you. Let's get rid of presence because we don't need it. I'm gonna add a new audio track. Say you wanted to track out separate tracks or several tracks at one time, you'd have to utilize your ins and outs on the back of your MPC, any one of your MPCs. So in this case, I only have two ins and outs as far as my interface goes. So I have one going through one and one going through three. I put the drums on outputs 3 and 4 in the MPC, and the sample is going out of output 1. The IO, you want to add a in and out for your mono, and you set your, you know, mono 1 or mono 2. For the stereo, it doesn't benefit in this case because I only have two ins and outs, right? So we do it the mono way. You delete that. Hit record. All right. So that's only the sample. So that just speeds up the workflow in a nutshell. If you have a bigger interface or a mixer with an interface, or mixers are interfaces in a nutshell, and it's, you could connect it to your computer via via USB to your DAW. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna try to show you guys how to set it up in multiple DAWs, just the part of using the network MIDI to see if it's actually working. All right, so I'm gonna close out of Studio One, and I'm probably gonna open up Reason. It's been a minute since I opened that up, but I'm gonna open it up to test it out. All right, quit this. I don't want to say. So we got Reason open. This is Reason Light. Automatically, when I open up the preferences on controller surfaces, the DAW control automatically was enabled. So I'm going to test out the differences to see if I can control any actual instruments in here. The audio though, I think I need to switch this to, I think I should be straight with the audio. Let me just set everything up and then I'll bring y'all back. Hold on. Reason seems to be a failure as far as I'm concerned. I can't get it to function right, but Ableton Link works as far as it's communicating to each other, right? But I'm not able to get it to play inside of Studio One, inside of Reason via Standalone. It's not communicating. As far as the DAW control, the Network MIDI DAW control, it's still not controlling the sounds in Reason. So Reason users, Standalone mode on your MPCs is not a current go right now. If any of you know how to get it to work, please post it up in the comment section how to do so, and or if you have a video that references it, I'd love to check it out. All right, I'm gonna see if I could what other DAWs I could open up, and then we're gonna close out. All right, so Logic is basically a failure. I got it to record, but it's doing the boo-boo the fool thing where the playback is wrong. That's not how it was looping, and it's not dragging from the one, so that defeats the purpose. As far as the MIDI controlling the any other instruments in Logic, no, I didn't get it to work. So that's it for that. I'm not even gonna try Fruity Loops because Fruity Loops is a headache with their settings. So that's pretty much it. There is one thing that I want to check though that I discovered just now, and I'm gonna see if it works inside of Studio One. If it don't work inside of Studio One, then I'll just close out. Hold up. That is it for the Akai Network MIDI. Again, you do need to install it. It comes, there's an additional installer that you download. It's called Akai Professional Network MIDI. Once you install that, you're then able to utilize the Wi-Fi on your MPC Live, MPC X, and the new coming MPC One. You connect it via the same network router of your household. Therefore, you won't have to connect a 5-pin MIDI to connect to your DAW. The only DAW that I'm able to get it to function how I want it to function, minus the controlling of other instruments, is Studio One. Reason failed for me, Logic failed for me, Pro Tools, I can't find my iLock, so I can't open up Pro Tools Lite right now, and that is the only other DAWs that I have. I don't have Ableton on this computer anymore. I'm gonna get it soon, but that's pretty much it, man. I know this video was all over the place. I'm gonna edit it up the best way that I know how. That's it, man. Do remember that music is life. It is our DNA. Keep banging. Peace, love, and light. Till next time. Peace. And if you have any questions, just post it up in the comment section, and from my knowledge of what I do know about the Network MIDI, I will help you. All right, peace.